Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel. Yes, sir. I'm feeling good. Yeah, no, we're fired up to get the win. I mean, that's a big time win. They're a really good team, you know. But you know, we're pushed past it. You know, just like you said, 24-hour rule. We celebrated, and now we're focused on UNT.
You finally have a bell cow back, and it's bringing the balance to your offense. How has Makhi stepped up in the last 2 games?
He's done a phenomenal job. You know, I think, you know, just things that we talk about being a Tulane guy, coming to practice, practicing hard every single day. You know, he does the little things right. And, you know, one of the best things I can say about him on the field is, you know, he doesn't take, you know, lost yardage plays. I feel like every single run that he has, he's always getting yards. He's driving his feet. He's getting extra yards. So those, you know, extra 2, 3, 4 yards every single play is huge. And I think he's done a really good job of that. I think just the you know, diversity of our offense, you know, being able to do a lot of different things, a lot of different formations, being able to run the ball effectively has really helped us and opened up our pass game, and vice versa, our pass game, you know, opened up our run game. So having a fully dimensional offense and being able to be successful in everything that we do is something that has opened up a lot of things for us.
What changed this second half Friday?
What was that?
What changed in the second half Friday? Was it adjustments or something?
I think the second half, you know, I think a lot of it was on me. I think the first half I was just not necessarily on my landmarks. I think I was seeing the field well and, you know, going through my progressions well, but I think just accuracy wasn't necessarily there. And I think after the half, you know, making some adjustments, I was making some more throws in the second half. But I think, you know, coaching wise in the first half was great. You know, play calls were awesome. You know, everybody was executing really well. I just had to make some throws and, you know, we fixed that up in the second half.
Probably not the right term, but were you frustrated with yourself going into halftime because there were several throws that you wanted to make that were there that you didn't make?
Yeah. Yeah, no, definitely. You know, I think just the timing and stuff like that, you know, not practicing every day of, you know, that week leading up to it, you know, just not being in rhythm was something that, you know, kind of hindered that. But I think, you know, just like you said, it was frustrating going into the half, but, you know, I had to regroup myself and, you know, come out and, you know, I thought I was seeing the field well and, you know, everything was there. I just had to make the throws.
You guys didn't flinch at all. They scored 3 straight touchdowns. And mm-hmm. There was really no negative reaction. What does that help? Just veterans on the team, what would that do? Would that get you if you just executed and you were going to be successful?
Yeah, no, I think that speaks to, you know, everybody on the team, you know, staying poised and, you know, staying in the moment and not worrying about, you know, the plays before and focus on the task at hand, you know, just the coaching, the character of everybody on the team and, you know, the leadership of staying focused on our goal and taking it play by play.
The 3rd and 12 completion, did that kind of get you going a little bit?
Yeah,
the one to Brown.
Yeah, to Ewell, the dig, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, no, I think that was big. He made a great play, ran a great route, and got some extra yards after the catch. So I think that was definitely big time on 3rd and 12, you know, prolonging that drive and going down and scoring.
Did it kind of get you going a little bit?
Yeah, I would say so, definitely.
What has Cam Badesco been to this team? He was one of the last guys. And then Andre Sam transferred. There was an mm-hmm. opening. He came in. And
yeah, no, he's a heck of a ball player. He's a really smart guy. He's really athletic. He can, you know, play man coverage. He's really smart. He can play zone. And I think he's just also a leader on the defense. You know, I think we got a lot of guys that have stepped up into leadership roles, but he's a very vocal guy, you know, for the defense and getting guys lined up and getting them in the right positions and, you know, him just handling business. He's a great tackler as well. So huge, huge asset to our defense.
What's the biggest
What was that? Yeah, no, he's done a phenomenal job. You know, I was talking about all offseason, you know, he was going to have a big year. You know, he's done a really good job in practice of, you know, being more physical, you know, winning one-on-one. You know, he's a big body. He's almost 6'5". You know, he can jump up and go get it. He can win one-on-one. He's got good speed. So, you know, having him, you know, backside at X and, you know, being able to do everything that he does is huge for our offense.
Focus and edge. There's a lot going on campus. There's a lot of
Yeah.
Does it help you guys? Does it energize you guys, or can it be a distraction too?
I think we're pretty locked in on, you know, the task at hand. I don't think that, you know, too many guys are doing too much extra stuff other than, you know, what we got going on for practice and film and all that kind of stuff. So I wouldn't say that it really has any negative effect on us. I think it's going to be a good environment on Saturday. You know, I think, like Coach, I think it's a sellout. So just having that crowd here and, you know, getting everybody fired up, I think it'll be a good asset.
What were your first impressions of Will Carroll when he arrived, and how effective has he been for you guys?
Yeah, he's been really good. You know, he's a really cool kid. He's a funny guy. We actually met him in Australia when a couple of us were there for a study abroad this summer. So got to meet him and, you know, get to know him a little bit. And he's just done a great job of, you know, being a big time guy in that spot.